Hello friends, now see we will discuss whatever important points regarding your what? Alcohol phenols and ethers. So in alcohol phenols and ethers, I already told, if you have to do strong preparation of your organic chemistry, so you must have to revise 11 organic topics, that is GOC. In that GOC, whatever constituents of GOC, nomenclature, okay, after nomenclature is what? General organic chemistry, then your isomerism part, okay. So these are what? Important part of your whatever is in 11th standard, organic chemistry, basic principle and dairy techniques, okay. So you have to concentrate on first these topics. In that electron displacement effects also there, okay, inductive effect, then electromeric effect, mesomeric effect. You go through that and some simple whatever aspects, means suppose alkyl groups are there. So alkyl groups, definitely they are increasing what? Basicity. If CN minus, then your aldehyde acid groups are there. So it will what? Increasing your acidity. So this simple knowledge you must know, okay. Some compounds, some substances, they are showing hydrogen bonding, okay. So means little bit simple concepts are there, but you have to do at any cost, otherwise your whole organic become what? You have to do that organic, you are strong, understood? So see here, in alcohol phenols and ethers, what we have to discuss. In alcohols, phenols and ethers, some monohydric alcohols are there, means like that examples, C2H5OH, okay. Then dihydric alcohols also there. What beta in that dihydric alcohol, CH2OH and CH2OH, okay. Trihydric alcohol, CH2OH, CHOH and what? CH2OH. It is in glycol, it is what? Beta glycerol. Okay. Again, you must know, you can identify primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol also. Okay. So primary alcohol, suppose I will write like this, CH2 double bond, CH, CH2OH. So is it primary? Yes. Is it primary? Because whatever this functional group, it is directly attached to one carbon atom, and that carbon is directly attached to one single carbon atom. So therefore it is what, beta? Primary alcohol. Yes, primary alcohol. Understood? Or we can write 1 degree alcohol. So like that you can identify your secondary alcohol also. Okay, suppose I will write like this, CH3, CHOH and CH3. So this is your functional group. It attached to this carbon atom, and this carbon is attached to another carbon atom. So that's why these two another carbon atom it will attach. Therefore, it is what, beta? Yes. Secondary alcohol, or we can say what, beta? Yes, 2 degree alcohol we can call. Understood? So after that phenols also like that, okay, monohydric, dihydric phenols, understood? So these are what simple examples of your alcohols. You must know, you can identify easily what primary, secondary and tertiary alcohols, okay. Then students might have confusing, what is the benzylic position? Okay. Or we can say, suppose I will write here, beta, what? Benzyl alcohol. Then second what? Yes. Allyl alcohol. Okay. And third is what, beta? Yes. Benzyl, allyl and vinyl. What, beta? Vinyl alcohol. So these are what? If we are considering these alcohols, so these alcohols, it is already over in your that first topic of organic in 11th standard. Means suppose if you are writing here benzylic alcohol, so see here as like this your benzylic alcohol, and you discuss in that stability of that benzylic carbocation also. So it will react fast. Okay. So see benzyl alcohol as like this CH2OH. Okay. So here polarity it will generate. So here what? Beta plus. So we call this only after removing this OH, we call it as a what? Yes, benzylic carbocation. What beta? Benzylic carbocation. And it's very, very much stable. After that, allylic alcohol. So see, CH2 double bond, CH, CH2, OH. So after removing this, here partial charge it will generate. So we call it as a what? Allylic carbocation. Okay, understood. So first this most stable, then this vinylic as like this CH2 double bond CHOH. So what you will get? Here sp2 carbon atom, here sp3, and here what beta? Yes, your sp3 carbon atom. So these all, so very means in last whatever paper I check in that, so many students they done mistake in that. Okay, they don't know where you have to break. So but here you must know where you have to break, like this you have to break. Just to benzylic, phenylalic and vinylic. Okay, so you have to concentrate on this alcohol. So that's why I revise here benzylic, allylic and what? Vinylic alcohols. Okay, like that we can like that I also discussed in previous video. Okay, what with a benzylic halide, then allylic halide, then vinylic halide. Okay, so means we can easy to memorize also that things. Understood? Then after that IUPAC nomenclature also you have to do from your NCERT. So beta, first you take your NCERT before watching that video. Okay, now in ether also they gave a nomenclature. Okay, now structure and functional group, OH as you know, phenol. Okay, then they gave what? Alcohol and phenols, preparation of alcohols they give. In that preparation of alcohols, okay, hydration of alkene they give. What beta? Hydration of alkene. So hydration of alkene, very much important is what? Mechanism. Okay, you must know this mechanism, hydration of alkene. Okay, then what beta? Second they give HBO. HBO is what? From alkene we can prepare your, yes, alcohol, means CH3 CH double bond CH2 by using this reagent, what? BH3. Okay, then BH3, then what? Tetrahydrofuran, then H2O2 oxidizing agent. Thereafter what? Base also. So we can directly convert into what? Alcohol. CH3, CH2, CH2OH. Okay, they give full of reaction of HBO in your NCERT. Understood? From carbonyl compound also. Means as you know, aldehyde on reduction what? Alcohol. Means suppose if you are considering this what? Aldehyde. So by using mild what? By using mild reducing agent like H2PD. So what beta you will get? RCH2H, means this CHO is converted to what? CH2H. Like that we can prepare. And suppose you, if you, I have to prepare this what beta? Yes, 1 degree alcohol. And suppose I have to prepare what? Secondary alcohol. So for that I have to use your ketone. So from ketone, with the help of this H2PD reducing agent, RCHOHR, means what? Secondary alcohol I can prepare easily. Understood? So like that preparation method also there. From Grignard reagent also very much important part. From Grignard reagent also we can prepare your alcohol, primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols. Okay. During preparation time, you can ask your queries from Grignard reagent or MGX. Very, very much important is part. Grignard reagent. Okay. You have to do this. If any doubt will come, then I will be there. Okay. Then preparations of phenols. So see in the preparation of phenols. What? From chlorobenzene also we can prepare phenol. Then what? Benzene sulfonic acid from diazonium salts. I mean directly from amine. Means all I already told. This one organic topic is not related to that only contain. It is related to whole of organic. Means in your haloalkanes and halorine, you prepared aldehyde also, you prepared acid also. Okay. You prepared amine also in that. So that's why these are what? Interrelated topics. So here you have to concentrate on this NCID. So see, from aniline they prepared phenol. Simple reactions are there. Then most important, from cumene also they prepare. So cumene is what beta? Isopropyl benzene. Isopropyl benzene. So see this isopropyl benzene your as like this. CH CH3. And here also what beta? Yes. CH3. These are what beta? Your isopropyl benzene. Or we can say what? Cumene. So from this we can prepare what? We can prepare your acetone, and along with acetone we prepare. Acetone is your byproduct, but your product is what? Phenol. We can prepare phenol. See all the reaction they give in your NCRT. Okay. Thereafter they give 11.4 and 11.5 NCRT in-text question. You must solve this. Very, very much important. 11.4, 11.5 NCRT exercise. You have to solve. Then you go through physical properties. How alcohol's boiling point it will affect with molecular mass, with hydrogen bonding. Okay. Then chemical reactions, okay, of alcohols also they gave. In that simple mechanism also they gave. Okay. And how your alcohol it will react with sodium. So see here, suppose your alcohol it will react with sodium. So what beta here? Yes. H plus it will O minus. So as you know, sodium is your what? Electropositive. So RONa plus what? H2 means here sodium alkoxide you will get. Sodium alkoxide you will get. Means here you prepare this sodium alkoxide. So you might have know one thing. We prepared sodium alkoxide in one reaction. So that reaction is what? Williamson synthesis reaction. Okay. So again in that Williamson synthesis reaction, it is there. Okay, in this topic only. So from phenol also we can prepare phenoxide ion. So here you must know acidity of alcohols in acidity of phenol. So these all theoretical parts you have to do. In that they gave yes phenol resonating structures. Okay, phenol resonating structures, then what? Then your phenoxide, what is the stability? If you are considering stability of that phenoxide ion, so you must know phenoxide ion resonating structure also. Okay, then why your phenol is acidic in nature by losing that proton. Okay, means whatever that all theoretical part, you read thoroughly and you can ask your doubts on that. Okay. And you can prepare whole now any means n number of questions on that contain. Okay. So whatever they gave information in that paragraph. Then esterification also there. Then as you know, what beta? One of the important reaction here they gave in your this topic, alcohol phenols and ether, that is preparation of aspirin. Aspirin. In that preparation of aspirin, so they gave what? Salicylic acid. Okay. So beta, here you must know what is the salicylic acid. COOH and what beta OH? This what beta here? salicylic acid. So here in salicylic acid plus what? Ac2o. This Ac2o is what? Acidic anhydride. Means I can write like this: CH3CO over twice and O. Okay, or we can write like this: CH3C double bond O, O C double bond O, and what beta? Your CH3. Okay, so here where reaction it will occur in the presence of acid. So see here what you will get: acetyl salicylic acid COOH. Here reaction it will occur O. Here it will break O, C double bond O, CH3, C double bond O, CH3 plus. Plus what beta? CH3, COOH, acetic acid. So these are what? These are what beta? Your acetyl, yes, acetyl salicylic acid. Means whatever this reagent, medicine, very much important medicine. During what? To relieve blood pressure, headache also, aspirin. Okay, so you must know, you know, Disprin, okay, mouth dissolving tablet. Okay, so like that, these also what? Very much important and commercial importance, this reaction, aspirin, preparation of aspirin. So here, you must know their common names also. Thereafter, they give one important mechanism. Okay, ethanol into diethyl ether. So beta, this mechanism you have to do very, very much important. Okay, so see that all step means formation of alcohol, then what? Formation of carbocation, then what? Elimination of proton. Okay, so these all whatever in preparation of from ethanol to diethyl ether. Okay, and after that they gave a mild reducing agent, sorry, mild oxidizing agent they gave. Means suppose if you have some doubly bonded, means CH3CH double bond CH2OH, like that compound is there. So we have to use what? PCC. So without disturbing this double bond, you will get what product? CH3CH double bond CH and what? CHO. Understood? So they give here examples of that also. So somewhere we can use copper also. Okay. Then electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. Reactions of phenols also they gave. In that intramolecular hydrogen bonding, intermolecular hydrogen bonding also you have to concentrate. Means all phenol reaction you have to do with the concentrated nitric acid phenol or concentrated nitric acid. What you will get? Okay, you will get picric acid to 4,6-trinitrophenol. Then halogenation. Okay, then intex version also there. Then most important Riemann reactions. Okay. Then I think your Kolbe reactions also there in that. Then you have to solve beta what? Whatever exists are index questions. 11.6 to 11.9. Kolbe reaction also means you must know here. You have to ask yourself question. Means what is the product of Riemann reaction? Or what starting reactant they use? Okay. Which electrophile they are? Understood? So at that time you have to take blank page and you have to write. Okay, understood? So here reading as well as writing both are important in chemistry. Understood? In any part, whether you are studying physical chemistry, inorganic chemistry, organic chemistry. Okay, then dehydration of alcohol. So see, in the preparation of means this, whatever this mechanism, okay, in that mechanism beta, what? Three only steps. First what? Protonation. Then what? Oxonium ion. Then what? Elimination of proton. Then you will get what? Ether. So beta, you have to do practice. If you are facing any doubts, you can ask during preparation time. Okay. But you have to do this by yourself first. Okay. Means You must now what active part? You have to take active participation in solving, in exercise solving. Then from reference book, any question it will came, then that you have to solve. Okay. It is basically what application based questions all are there. So in Williamson synthesis reaction, okay, here so much important whatever in Williamson synthesis, okay. So Rx plus RONA, so in that Rx plus RONA, so see here, whatever they gave in that tertiary, sodium tertiary butoxide plus what, plus your bromo alkane, then what you will get, they will get what, suppose here CH3CH3CH3ONA plus what, CH3Br. So whenever such type of reaction it will come, what will happen, here minus, here plus, okay, then here what, plus, here minus, yes, so minus plus it will join CH3CH3, then CH3OCH3 plus what, beta NaBr. Okay, means here what, simply ether you will get. Okay, we can call it as a what, that ether, what, tertiary butyl methyl ether we can call. Okay, and suppose reverse condition it is there. So in the reverse condition, what will happen? Yes, see here, beta. CH3C, CH3, CH3 and Br, okay, plus NaOCH3. So here, beta, it is a competition between substitution over elimination. So see here, what will happen, beta? Elimination. CH3C double bond CH2. Okay, CH3C double bond CH2, and what here? Yes, CH3. So, or we can, beta, we can form here like this. So see here. So why it will happen here? Because this sodium methoxide, it will act at the base also. So as you know, property of base is what? To abstract hydrogen. Means suppose I will write like this, this CH3, CH2H. So this hydrogen bond, it will break. Okay, and form bond between this C and C. So Br means HX minus HBr it will lock. So what you will get product? CH3C, CH3, yes, double bond CH2 plus what, beta? Yes, NaBr, and what? Yes, plus CH3OH. So these are what, byproduct. So if you not wrote byproduct, it is also okay, because in organic chemistry you have to write, you have to concentrate on your product only. Okay, why it will happen? Because whatever this sodium methoxide or sodium alkoxide, it act as a nucleophile as well as strong base. So they gave reason here, okay, why that reaction. Then you have to solve, or you have to concentrate on physical properties also, understood, in text questions also, all ether reaction also, anisol reaction, anisol on halogenation, anisol on nitration, okay, anisol on acylation, anisol on alkylation, that also you have to say, and with insight in text question and exercise. Don't skip that part if you want a good score in this 10th November exam, what, that is our round second. Okay, I hope you understood all this content. If you have any doubts, you can share or you can ask during preparation time. So thank you very much.